Hey everybody, Arco here. Welcome to round one of another tournament, this time of the Blizzards Open. So all the FFA games in this tournament will feature Blizzards, which will make for some potentially interesting spawn holds here. Alright, we go third. Where is our bonus gonna be? Man, we got flipping nothing on the right half. Make sure to ally everybody. Slash accept. Alright, so plus three and or plus four might be our play we go for. And white takes that. So these are the settings for round one. It's Operation Atom, 90 seconds, fog off, blizzards on, alliances on, unstable portals. Then players in the lobby, we got Mr. Potterhead, Master, probably a technical Grandmaster, Crackle, Master, technically Grandmaster, ourselves, and then we got King Hezzy, Grandmaster, Roland Evangelist, a beginner, and finally General Rivers, a Grandmaster. So Crackle's got a free bonus right away. Just gonna look for another bonus there soon. Okay, so Pink has a free... a free bonus there. Where are the portals going? We are owning a lot of these portals, actually. Gonna have to make a claim for both of these maybe to survive. Then looking to fortify this stuff in at the top. Do that now. We'll look to fortify that into one of these two bonuses next turn. Ooh, rough dice for Hezzy there. One of these guys may steal that. Yeah, Pink takes two free bonuses right off the bat. That's really good for them. Are these both plus twos? Yeah, they're both plus twos. Pink moves in, gives that to red. Let's see if we can ask Crackle to roll out his two for us. Make this bonus hold a little bit easier. Damn. White lost nothing there, so they're gonna get. Fairly easy second bonus. Thank you, Crackle. All right, and we don't have the troop generation here to fight pink, I don't think. Yeah, we'll move out of there. Is this fixed? So we aren't necessarily weak, but we aren't necessarily strong either. Doesn't look like pink's gonna pressure for a third bonus here. Okay, Rivers takes his second bonus. Okay, we have another portal on our stack up there. Ooh. Minus four on there for white. Yeah, we're gonna have to invest in our position up north here. portal blocked up. Right, no set on three. Alright, so let's see. Crackles generating plus six. Potters generating plus six. Rivers plus six. Hezzy plus six. And then Pink and I. Roland and I plus four. And it looks like we're going to be in this type of game for a little while. Ten trade for Hezzy. Okay, we have a six trade with a plus two. Thinking we will take that. We've all done a good job at roughly evenly distributing all these bonuses around. don't think we risk going to five here. We also need to defend this portal. Oh, yeah, we would have gotten another horse anyway, unless that's one of the cards I helped influence the deck by smashing that in. And trade for pink. If nobody dies within the next few turns or so, we may see this game go on for a little bit. This is likely already gonna come down to whoever throws the most thumbs up in the alliance chat or something. Ah, Potter was holding all the cannon cards. Okay, four trade for Crackle. Alright, I think this is a 10 set. Nice, okay. That's a bit reassuring. Because based off of bonus generations alone, either Pink or myself is going to be the one teamed on. Just by troop counts and all that stuff. Gotta hope it's gonna be somebody else. another portal shift here. Alright, we get another cannon right back. Gonna have a bunch of this, I guess. Not really interested in hitting pink. Ooh. The portal movement. Okay. That could hit a lot of different spots, because the portal is at least one portal aimed at everybody. It's not a set for us. Oracle stack doesn't do much. Got the set. Yeah, I guess this is the one downside of the good neighbor mindset being so prevalent in the current meta at the moment, is that we're a tiny bit too kind to each other. Like early on, Red could have been teamed on, I could have been teamed on. Pink could have pressured for that third bonus early on. There are a few different things that could have happened to early on to where the game would have been sped along quickly, but it would have been at the expense of one to two people's game. Shuffling around up there again. Okay. Nice. Oh boy. It's pretty smart for Crackle to keep this line open in case White wanted to move through his bonuses to hit either red or blue. Hey, set up three. Helps us stay somewhat close to the back of the pack. Lowest bonus generation, yet I am the first one to a 69's deck. Something different is happening. Ah. Not quite. He tried to make the 69 stack and it didn't go to plan. Lost a troop. No set this time around. That's okay. Oh. Interesting. Okay. Blue takes a third bonus. Reduces pink to two positions. We unfortunately do not have a card now. Oh, nice. Crackle gave us one. I'm not sure what to respond to that for red yet, because if I hit the 46, that leaves me very weak. To where I'm just going to be getting teamed on next. Plus, Pinko's after me in the turn order. Meaning I can't really do it on turns with unstable portals open. Alright, nice. We got the slightly better trade. So that emote mean pink has no trade on four, or are they gonna try something here? Just a no trade on four emote, okay. Red's making another corner position through the portal. Pretty well played. Oh shit. Okay. Well, that just happened. Does Rivers full send in response? think so. And then gives that bonus up entirely. To cut out there for a second. There's two portals in my bonus, but I don't think that matters. I'm assuming some kind of alliance chat is going on involving Pink and someone else. See, where does pink move that back? Only moves one. Yeah, it moves back, sure. It is fixed, so missing a card isn't really the end of the world. And if I break blue for a card, he has a portal I can come over and whack my 10. Sand a pink, I would like to preferably not hit my 10 for a card in fixed. Are they gonna do it anyways? Let's see. Okay, they don't. Oh, they were hovering it. Look at that arrow delay. They were gonna do it last second. All right. Interesting. Now portals are closing. Okay. Don't see the stack move up, so it'll be on the portal again. Rivers opens it up now. I do have a one to hit this turn. Strange bit of delay there. Everything okay still, I hope. Oh. Alright, got the same card. Alright, a little bit of lag on my end, I guess. Oh shit. Nice. Okay. Blue and pink smacked each other enough, and I go before red, so I get the bounty. Huzzah! Oh, man. What a weird game. Guess it's not too strange of a game, but still. Okay. Get the two cards. We'll stay on the portal. Still leave a 10 back here. We now have a second bonus. GG to Roland Evangelist. All right, let's see who goes for Blue's Bounty. If Crackle goes for it, Crackle probably goes for it. Depending on the rolls he gets, it might be worth to try and kill him right after. Only if he gets really bad rolls, though. Actually, no, he'd have to get stupidly bad rolls. Okay, yep, he takes the kill. What was his dice? 49 on the 69. Damn, okay. Can maybe claim another bonus for ourselves here. Move that off the portal since it's about to close anyway. So now what's going on? White still has the plus six. I now have a plus eight. Got three, three, three is a nine. And then 2, 3, 3, 4 is 12. Okay. Where are these portals going? Crackle's looking for third and two. Well, looks like we're gonna have to be in a war for third and two, hopefully. Let's hope red and white help out by breaking bonuses at the very least. Okay, red doesn't help. Okay. Well, let's see if Crackle gets it through Balance Blitz BS. Minus 14. Minus 4. Yeah, probably has it. Yeah. All right. So we get fourth and one off that. Did not expect Crackle to immediately settle for third and two that quickly. So I guess in hindsight, I should have broke more of his bonuses. Also unfortunate that we did not have a trade there on four. So I guess red and white only gave me a thumbs up since they didn't want my 130 to break their bonuses or something. Dang, red's not gonna take the kill or anything. Doesn't hit white. Okay. So Potter might get the win here just off speed alone. Actually, his 115 is stuck. Oh yeah, the 29 takes care of the left, and then the 184 can blast through. No? Come on, you can move through. You can get the win right here. Not doing it. Wow. What the hell is going on? Okay, Crackle's trying to negotiate for a second. Yeah, 7-on-3. Okay, red gets the bounty. Right, so King Hezzy gets 2nd and 1. And then Crackle gets 3rd and 2. Potter gets 1st and 1. Then it's myself, 4th and 1. River's 5th. Rolling 6. Good cleanup. Should end on this turn. Good game to Mr. Potterhead for the win. Needs to click on territories. Hey, he gets it in time. Well done. All right. So that was an annoyingly long fixed game, but based on our spawn, getting fourth and one isn't too terrible of a result. I could have tried to play for third and second myself, I guess. I just didn't expect Crackle to immediately try to do that straight away. But I guess he saw the troop deficits and how long the game has been, so just probably wanted it over with, to be honest. But all right. So that was round one. The Blizzard's open. Round two will be sometime next week, depending on the scheduling, of course. GG's again to all of our opponents. And until next time, everybody, take care. Cheers for stopping by.